Hello there. Welcome. Thank you for joining as you come in. Thank you for joining as you come in, share. Thank you for sharing. Hello there. Hello there. Thank you for joining, Tashlyn. Thank you for sharing. I'm just going to share this to my page. Really quickly. Thank you for joining. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for commenting as you come in. Let me know you are here. Hi, Angela. How are you? Thank you guys for sharing. Listen, share this to your page. Share it to your followers. Thank you for watching the live feed, and thank you for watching the replay. Thank you for sharing to your page. Thank you for inviting your followers on. I appreciate your time. I'm not gonna be on here extremely long today. We're just gonna get on here and release the three words that Holy Spirit dropped in my spirit this morning. I'm gonna share that with you, and I'm gonna get off and we're gonna go about our day. Hallelujah. Thank you for sharing. Look, share this video to your page, to your followers. Thank you for joining. Hallelujah. We bless you guys. Hi, Bianca. Thank you for joining. Thank you guys for joining. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for watching this live broadcast. And thank you for watching the replay. I appreciate your time. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for joining. Thank you for watching the replay. Good morning. I pray you guys are doing well. I just want to get on here and encourage you. I'm going to drop three words, and then we're going to get off here. Just three words. Type that in the comments. Just three words. And I think these three words are beneficial as it is right now, where the world is and where you may even be in your own life. I just want to drop these three words. Holy Spirit spoke to me this morning. I was kind of between two things, like, okay, should I release this? Or should I release that? And Holy Spirit, while I was in devotion and just meditation with God, He released a word, three words, and I'm just going to release those three words, and we're gonna get off here, and we're gonna go about our day. Let me encourage you today. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for watching the replay. Just three words. We're just going to release those three words. We're going to talk about those three words. We're going to pray. And we're going to be gone. Thank you for joining. Listen, share this with your friends. Share this with your followers. Invite somebody on. Let them know that we are live and we are ministering this morning. Hi, Sierra. Thank you for joining, guys. Share this. Hi, Drill. Thank you for joining, guys. Share this to your timeline. Invite somebody on. Let somebody else be encouraged by just three words. We're going to type those three words in when we release those, but type in the comments. Just three words. Holy Spirit, that's all He gave me this morning. He said, just three words. And I'm going to release those three words. Type that in the comments. Just three words. All He wanted to release unto us today was just three words. I know there's so many things that's been being released and so many things that God is saying right now, so many things that He's doing right now, so many people are experiencing moves of God, manifestations, encounters with God. They're experiencing God tugging on them to come closer in the power place. But I just want to release just three words. Just three words. Hi, Iona. Thank you for joining. Guys, look, share this to your timeline. Invite someone on. Invite your followers. I am Prophetess Sherry. Bedford Downs. And I thank you for watching the live feed, and I thank you for watching this replay. You can find me on YouTube, or you can subscribe to the channel and receive further encouragement, enlightenment, direction, instruction, prophetic. We're just releasing the things that God lays on our heart, and we're doing that in the platform of social media. We're doing that via YouTube, and we're doing that via Facebook. So just three words. And guess what, my friends? You are still here. You are still here. And that says something. That says that God has plans for you to prosper you and to give you hope, a future, and an expected end. There is an end that's planned for you, and there's plans for you to move into the next move of God, because you are still here. You are not defeated. You are not cast out. You are not forsaken. You are not destroyed. You are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus, created unto good works. God has a plan for you, and it's to prosper you. It's to excel you. It's to push you to the next place of purpose, to push you to the next place of your calling, to push you to the next place with God, to push you to the next place in your business, to push you into the marketplace, to push you into the next place of understanding, enlightenment, and to further solidify who He is in your life, because truly He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You could have been taken out a long time ago, and God protected you. He invested so much in you, friend. He invested angelic protection. He invested encouragers. He invested motivators. He invested people that came and undergirded you and pushed you to the next place of purpose. You are still here. And because you're still here, you are an overcomer. You are anointed to win. You are anointed to prosper because you are still here. You are victorious. You are a warrior. You are the righteousness of God created unto good works. You are victorious through Christ Jesus. You are triumphant. You made it through everything that you've been through thus far. You are still here. Type in the comments, I am still here. And because you're still here, God has plans for you. He wants to use you. He wants to push you. He wants to get you to that next place in ministry. He wants to get you to that next place in understanding. He wants to get you to that next place of purpose, because you are still here. Friend, it's not your time to give in. It's not your time to back down. It's not your time to throw in the towel. It's not your time to be overcome by anxiety, depression, worry, stress, financial strain. It's your time to experience just three words. Type in the comments, just three words. The Lord released just three words to me this morning. He didn't give me a whole big to-do list to release today. He said, just release these three words to my people. I want them to know what I'm saying in this hour concerning them. Those that will connect and watch this live broadcast, those that will watch the replay, it is not by happenstance. It's not by a coincidence that you clicked on, that you're listening. It is by divine appointment, because there's nothing that happens in my life by coincidence, because the Lord is on my life, and the hand of the Lord is on my life, and the hand of the Lord guides my life. So if God released to me just three words to release to you today, my friends, it is by His divine order that you hear just three words. So I want to encourage you to take these three words. I want to encourage you to be led by these three words. I want to encourage you to pray into these three words. I want to encourage you to ask God to give you further revelation concerning these three words. I want you to just press in to just three words. Just three words. It's Father, Son, Holy Spirit. That's not the three words, but He did just give me three words, and He began to just show me these three words and how we can utilize these three words to get us to the next place in our purpose, in our destiny, in alignment with what God is saying concerning your life, concerning your future. Just Three words can be so significant in this hour. Three words can turn your life around. Just these three words can cause you to step into the next manifestation of your victory, of purpose, of destiny, of the fulfillment of the plan of God over your life. Just three words, friends. Type in the comments if you haven't already. Just three words. Come on, agree with me. God wants me to know right now, just three words. Three words that God wants to release to you to cause you to push, to cause the flow of heaven to happen in your life. The Lord just began to show me of the word stimulus, and he began to show me a well, a dry well. Some of us have been experiencing dry seasons. We've experienced a season of dryness. Maybe that's spiritually in your understanding, a season just of drought. But God says, even during this season, though, the key words that's manifesting in the earth are, listen to these key words, guys, stimulus, right? That's one. Type that in the comments. These aren't the three words, but I just want to highlight prophetically the words that God is speaking into the earth, right? And we're just going to break these three words down and prophetically open these words up. But the highlight of the three words, I'm going to release that after I prophetically open up the key words that are being heralded on every news station that's being perpetuated, on every timeline. Every body is saying these key words, stimulate, right? And I began to look up that word, stimulate, stimulus. And it is to pump or prime something to get a flow happening, right? So as the economy released a seed in $1,200 or $1,700, depending on who you are, they've released that seed in such an hour of breakthrough, right? We are breaking through to overthrow and to get overflow. The body of Christ began to break through and ask God to release finances, to release the things that God has for the kingdom of God. And even as the children of Israel were exiting out of Egypt, they exited with goods. They exited with a stimulus package. They exited with something to carry into the next place of promise. They exited with an overflow. So even as many of us have received a stimulus package, that thing is not just to happen at one time. It is for you to take that seed and begin to decree and declare that the overflow and the abundance of God manifests with that seed. You, like in the old days, they had wells, and when the well would begin to be dry, they would use a pump to prime the well to bring an overflow. They would use the pump and prime and pump until that overflow began to happen. So they put in just a little bit of water to stimulate the pump so that the pump can release the overflow. So I want to prophetically, based off that word being released, I want to release that the overflow of God would manifest in your life, as even we've released the seed of stimulus has been released into our lives, that we will begin to position ourselves in the power place and begin to pray into overflow. I just don't want to be stimulated in this hour financially and spiritually, economically, but I want to decree and declare in my life and now in your life that God would just begin to release the overflow. The stimulus just doesn't happen for the economy, but the stimulus happens in your house. Oh, maybe this is too much for you. Maybe you can't see it in the realm of the spirit, but there are some things that I've been waiting on. There's some things, some promises that you've been waiting on. There's a flow in the spirit that you've been believing God to happen, whether that flow is in relationship, domestically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, in your prayer closet, in your whole life. You're asking God to change change your whole life. Allow that word that's being released in this hour to be your power place, to carry that word into the power place that you can experience the stimulation of heaven, that seed would then produce a harvest of overflow. I'm looking for the overflow of God. I'm looking not just for the $1,700 to manifest in my bank account, but I decree and I declare that the overflow would happen from the stimulus. Type in the comments and decree and declare and agree with that overflow in my house. It's just not enough to receive $1,700 to sustain me for today, but I prophesy and I release an overflow of abundance, that there will be momentum and release for the things of God, the promise of God, the position of God. So that word is a key word in this hour. And then I began to look at essential. Type in the comments, essential. It's essential that you press into the kingdom of God right now. It's essential that you are coming to the kingdom for such a time as this. You are an essential individual in the power place. It's essential that you step into your purpose. It's essential that you step into your destiny. It's essential that you hear God. It's essential. You are an essential, intricate part of the body of Christ. You are essential in your bloodline. You are essential in your generation. You are an essential part of your family. You are essential in the body of Christ. If you are essential in this hour, you were born for such a time as this. You were brought to the kingdom for such a time as this. You are essential. You are an essential individual. It's important that you survive. It's important that you are covered. It's important that you make it through. That's why God's invested so much in you down through the years, when you thought situations would take you out, when you thought it was over for you, when you thought that sickness would take you out, when you thought that relationship would drive you crazy, when you thought you would not make it out of the abuse, out of the loneliness, out of the depression, out of the anxiety. God said and decreed and declared and sang over your life a song of essential. Esther was essential. Joseph was essential. David was essential. Joseph was essential. Joseph could not stay in Canaan with his father and his brothers. He could not stay in that land, but he had to be sold into slavery to get him out of the famine and into a position of authority, because he was essential. I know it doesn't look that way because the road that you had to take, but listen, my friends, listen, my brother, listen, my sister, God says over you right now that you are essential. Type in the comments, I am essential. I'm essential to the body of Christ. I'm essential to my children. I'm essential to my workplace. I'm essential in this hour, especially right now. If you are a healthcare worker, you definitely are essential. You see how that works? Healthcare workers and those that keep things going are essential right now. We need them. You are essential in this next move of God. The gifts that you have, they are essential. Your voice is essential. So then the next word that's highlighted to me, that being pushed out into the earth, is frontliners, those that are on the front line, those that are on the front line, those that go in the front, those that are set in the front of the battle, those that are dealing with the nitty-gritty, those that are had their hands in the mess, those that are positioning themselves to be aid to this season and this hour. Many people are calling those who are healthcare workers, those who are pushing the agenda of health and are essential to the recovery of those that are sick. But I want to look at that in the realm of the spirit, and I want to decree and declare those of you that are intercessors, those of you that have been praying for your husband, praying for your children, you've been on the front line of battles, you've been been on the front line and you've gotten wounded. You've put yourself out there time and time again. You've taken hit after hit in your family, on your job, whatever area. You've taken those hits and you've taken those hits to the cross. You have been pleading with God. You've been pleading with God to heal. You've been pleading with God to deliver. You've been on the front line. You've experienced turmoil. You've experienced pain. You've experienced being talked about. You've experienced being shunned. You've experienced not feeling like you are needed, but you are on the front line of battle. So God is saying he's undergirding you in this hour. He's strengthening you in this hour. Even those that are intercessors and those that have been praying and interceding for the body of Christ, you are on the front line of the battle. And I decree and declare, as you keep going, as you hold to the horns of the altar, and as you keep praying and pressing in to the power place, that God is releasing a reward to you. There's being a reward. There's a reward is planned when you come out of this, just as the president and the political leaders are strategizing, trying to find a stimulus package that can aid those people that are in the healthcare industry, those that have put their lives on the line. When you take up prayer, when you take up the low road, when you begin to humble yourself under God and you begin to take hits and shots, these people that are on the front lines, they are putting their lives on the line. And as an intercessor, as one that sees the greater need, as one that can house the ability to care for somebody else in the realm of the spirit, when sickness hits, spiritual sickness hit, sin hits, you go to God in your power place, and you begin to get on the front line of that battle, and you begin to believe God for the outcome. You believe God for the shift. You believe God for the change. I prophesy to you that there is reward coming for your labor. So essential, reward, front line, stimulus, hallelujah. Those are three words that I wanted to highlight. But listen, that's not the three words that God released in my spirit. Those weren't the three words that God released in my spirit. He just prophetically highlighted those three words. But these are the three words in order to get to the place of overflow, in order to get to the place of victory, in order to get to the place of purpose, in order to excel to the next place that what God is doing in the earth, in order to get the manifestation of heaven to happen in your life, in order to transition to the promise of God, the manifestation of your purpose, your destiny, your call, your ministry, your assignment, the next place in your vision, the next place in your business. I prophesy and I believe that God is opening up the heavens, and those that will position themselves in this hour with just these three words, type in the comments, just three words. These three words will position you to receive the manifestation of the promise of God. These three words will put you in a place to receive not only breakthrough, but they'll put you in a place of dominion where you experience overthrow. It's not enough to go from breakthrough to breakthrough. I want to stand in a position of authority where I can have overflow in my life, and I'm overthrowing and overturning all the works of darkness. He says, behold, I've given you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and nothing shall by any means harm you. Do you know what kind of power that is? When he's giving you power to tread on, my friend, my brother, my sister, you have stepped in a place of overthrow. You have stepped in a place of dominion. You have stepped in a place of identity. You have stepped in a place of walking with God. Behold, I've given you the power to tread on serpents and scorpions, to overthrow all the power of the enemy. The enemy does not have authority. You have the authority, but God says it's through these three words. Type in the comments, just three words. It's through these three words that Holy Spirit spoke to me, that if you want to reign. If you want to see the promise of God, if you want to see God reign in your life, if you want to see the manifestation of victory, if you want to see your vision come to pass in your business, if you want to see your children step into ministry at a young age, if you want to see the legacy of God, if you want to experience the overflow of God, if you want to experience the abundance of God, if you want to experience the freedom of God, if you want to have encounters with God, if you want to move to the next place in dimension, in authority, in reign, where you see the manifestation of your labor, where you see a property, where you see the hand of the Lord, where you see the Abrahamic covenant come to pass in your life, where you see, not that I die, but I shall live to see the manifestation of the promise of God, not in the generation to come, but in my lifetime. He said, it's through these three words. Type in the comments, just three words. That's what separates you from the promise and the fulfillment of the promise. I want to go from declaring the promise to walking in the promise. I decree and I declare that 2020 shall be a year of manifestation for me and for you. I decree and declare that 2020 shall yield an abundance. 2020, we shall walk in the dreams that God has placed on the inside of us. 2020, we shall go past barriers. 2020, we shall see the hand of the Lord in full measure. 2020, we shall go from decreeing a thing to establishing a thing. I decree and declare in 2020, everything that we need to fulfill the assignment of the Lord, to fulfill the prophetic anointing, the prophetic forecast over your life, to fulfill those promises that your grandmother prayed, that your mother prayed, that your father prayed. I decree and declare by just these three words that we'll see the manifestation of God. We are shifting, my friend. We are shifting. Woo! Those of us that have been in the power place, those of us that have had our hearts on the altar, those of us that have been saying, God, search me and know me. Try the reins of my heart. In this hour, Father, I turn my life over to you. I turn my thought process over. Those of us that have been pressing in, those of us that have been turning our table, our plate over, those of us that have been seeking God, those of us that have partnered with God, it's something to see it, but it's another thing when you begin to partner with God. When you begin to partner with God, flesh has to go. When you begin to partner with God, you have to see things from another perspective. When you begin to partner with God, the way you thought, you can't think anymore. When you begin to partner with God, something on the inside shifts and there's a change that takes place. When you begin to partner with God, you humble yourself under his hand. So just three words. Type that in the comments. Just three words. It's just these three words that separate the wheat and the tare. It's just three words that separate the victim from the victor. It's just rebasa. It's just three words that separate the barren from the fruitful. It's just three words. And those three words that God spoke to me this morning as I was in meditation, he said, Sherry, tell them and tell you, come up higher. Come up higher. Type in the comments. Come up higher. Come up higher. He said, come up higher. Yes, you thought you had it down pat. Yes, you have a flow going with your business. Yes, you have a flow going in prayer. Yes, you have a flow going in other areas. But these three words will cause you to experience the overthrow, will cause you to experience the manifestation of the promise of God, that will cause you to experience the purpose of God, that will cause you to experience those things that you've only dreamed about, the abundant in the constant flow of provision. I decree and I declare, just as we've seen in days of old, Abraham had a covenant with God. Do you have a covenant? Job had a covenant with God. Do you have a covenant? Joseph had a covenant with God. Do you have a covenant? And if we take a survey of their lives, they experience an overflow and an overthrow. It's not to say that they didn't have opposition, because opposition will come, because you are on the opposite side. So the enemy is always going to try to get you to relent. He's always going to try try to get you to throw in the towel. He's always going to try to get you to stop praying for so that you won't see. But God says if you come up higher, when you come up higher, you are moving from one place to the next. Coming up higher involves action. Coming up higher involves a doing. Coming up higher involves something. Let me calm down. So these three words, type in the comment: come up higher. Come up higher. God, what is it that you're showing me in this hour? God, what is it that I need to see in this hour? What thinking process does it lend to the next place of purpose? What is it that you are testing in this hour? What areas of my life do I need to come up higher in? He says, my ways are not your ways, and my thoughts are not your thoughts. The way I do things, he says, is different than the way you do things. The way I see things is different than the way you see things. The way I think about things is different than the way you think about things. So then we have to go back to his word, and we have to say, God, I'm facing an impossible situation. I'm facing a crisis. Grant me the ability to execute crisis management. See, that's the problem. Some of us don't understand crisis management. You don't know how to manage a crisis. You don't know how to go into the place of power where you're more powerful, where you're able to get results in the realm of the natural, where you're able to execute laws and change things and break chains and break covenants, break up the plans of the enemy. You have to understand crisis management. Job understood crisis management when he got an understanding of what God was doing, when he got an understanding of who God was, because at first he was trying to roll this thing over in his mind with his friends. He was trying to get an understanding of what was manifesting in his life and why he was going to his friends. He said, no, I didn't do that. No, I didn't sin. No, that's not my lot. No, I can't curse God and die. So what Job did, he went to God. You have to learn in crisis to go to God. Are you experiencing crisis? Are you feeling like you're in a crisis? You know, for the kingdom of God, crisis is an opportune time to create. Crisis is an opportune time to create. What will you do now? Will you stand in crisis, or will you stand in the posture of creating? You are the creation. So as being the creation, you are anointed to produce. Hallelujah. So just three words. These three words are come up higher. Come up higher. Come up higher. Come being an action word, to move or travel toward or into a place thought of as near or familiar to the speaker, to occur, happen, take place. So it is an action word. In order to come, you have to move. In order to come, you have to move. In order to come, you have to move. So move up higher. And up. Up, this word up is toward a higher place or position. Toward a higher place or position. Move toward a higher place. Move toward a higher place. Come up higher. Move toward a higher place. So higher is a great vertical extent. At or to a considerable or specified height. So in moving towards a considerable or specified height, let's look at this. What areas is God calling you higher in? If he tells us my ways are not your ways, my thoughts are not your thoughts, then what ways is God calling you higher? What ways is he asking you to come up higher? Is he asking you to come up higher in understanding his ways? Purity, prayer, authority, dominion, emotional stability, mental stability, spiritual discernment. What ways is God asking you to come up higher? Is he asking you to come up higher in your relationship, in your dealings with your children, in your dealings with your spouse, in your dealings with your boss? What ways is God asking you to come up higher? Is he asking you to come up higher in purity, letting some things and people go, places go? We are seated in heavenly places. We cannot sit in a seat of authority in heavenly places, but we are void of moving higher to a specified or considerable amount or height. We cannot sit in that seat of authority if we're not willing to come up higher. Ephesians 2 and 6, and God hath raised us up together and made us to sit in heavenly places. We are seated in heavenly places. And when we are seated in heavenly places, we have to learn how to govern. We have to learn how to govern. We have to learn how to govern in heavenly places. We have to learn how to carry ourselves in heavenly places. We have to learn how to respond in crisis management and crisis situations. The process by which a business or organization deals with the sudden emergency situations that it faces. That is crisis management. When you are faced with a sudden crisis, how do you deal with those situations? God wants us to come up higher. Just three words. I love you guys with the love of the Lord, and I love you with my love. Father, we thank you for my friends, my brothers and my sisters that have decided to join us today. I pray, Father, that they would come up higher in every area, Father, that you've dealt with them. I pray, Father, that they would hear your voice and that they would move and sit in that seat of authority and begin to take, Father, their position in prayer, their position in the kingdom, their position in business, in the marketplace. They would rise to the occasion. They would rise to purpose. They would rise to destiny. I prophesy a come up higher anointing over you in Jesus' name. I love you guys with the love of the Lord, and I love you with my love. Be encouraged, be blessed, be strengthened, come up higher.